was that? It sounded like pieces flying everywhere. Then you heard the gasp. You run into the room the crash came from. Your creation was scattered all over the floor. There, standing in the middle of the wreck, was your brother, staring in shock at all the tiny pieces. "What have you done?" you yell. "You broke my creation!" With tears streaming down his face, your brother says, "I just wanted a closer look, and it slipped out of my hands." Your Lego creation is in shambles.
"I'm very mad at you this time. I'm not going to forgive you. Now stay out of my room!"
The words you say are harsh. Your temper is hot. Your face is red with anger, and you want to hit him. But that will only cause more trouble. You want to get even and break your brother's toys. Instead, you storm to your bedroom to cool off. In a few minutes, you hear a small knock on your bedroom door. The door cracks open. Your brother peeks in.
"I'm really sorry.
I really was just looking at it and it slipped." Now, what do you do? You may have had a similar experience. You may have been the person whose things were broken. Or maybe you were the person who did the breaking. The bigger question is, what now? How do you move forward? Well, let me give you a wonderful example to follow. God made a wonderful creation. The world and everything in it. He was very pleased with all he had made and said, "It is good." Then we came along, and by our choices, we messed things up. Lying, cheating, stealing, hating, disrespect for others, damaging the world God made for us to live in, and making things or people more important than God have created a huge canyon between us and God. Our sins, or the wrong things we do, are not an accident or an oops. When we sin, we deliberately choose to break the commands of God. This deliberate action is so severe that the Bible describes it this way. It's your sins that have cut you off from God. Because of your sins, He has turned away and will not listen anymore. Isaiah 59:2. Because we turned from God and wanted our own way, what God made as good, we've made bad. What God intended as pure, we polluted. What God made perfect is now broken and cracked. From the youngest to the oldest, each one of us has been part of ruining God's wonderful creation and keeping the relationship between God and us broken. For everyone has sinned. We all fall short of God's glorious standard, Romans 3:23. I'm sure God's heart must be broken when He sees that the world He made and the relationship He wanted with the people He created are now in shambles. God would have had every right to slam the door, turn His back on us, and let us face His anger. But this is where God's way is different. In spite of the pain we caused Him, God still chose to love us. He still wants to have a right relationship with us. In spite of us breaking His heart, God chooses to forgive. Here's what God wants to do. "I will show loving kindness to them and forgive their sins. I will remember their sins no more." Hebrews 8:12. But here is the other side of the coin. We also have to do something. Now, the first thing we need to do is admit that we are part of the problem. We have disobeyed God. We have lived our lives totally to please ourselves. Our words and our actions have made God look bad. Like the Bible says, no one is righteous. Not even one. Romans 3:10. The second part should be the easiest, but for most of us, it's the most difficult. we have to repent. To repent means to go in the opposite direction. We need to turn away from doing things our own way and ask God to forgive us for making such a mess. The message that Jesus' cousin, John the Baptist, preached was repentance. When Jesus began preaching, his message was also that we needed to repent of the bad things we have done and to turn to God. Now, for some great news. If we repent and ask God to forgive us, we can be sure he does. Oh, I love this verse. But if we confess our sins to him, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all wickedness. 1 John 1:9. When our sins have been forgiven, then God has removed our sins as far from us as the east is from the west. Psalm 103:12. Now that's a bonus. Once forgiven, our sins are gone and we stand in a right relationship with God. Coming back to the broken Lego creation. If you choose to forgive your brother, peace will be restored.
I'm sorry even more than you.
After all, you can build it again. On the other hand, if you stay mad, bitterness and anger and hatred will ruin everything you do, like a bad tangerine spreads throughout the whole box of fruit until it's all moldy. If you were the brother who accidentally broke the Lego creation, go to the one you hurt and say you're sorry and ask for forgiveness. Who knows what will happen? Maybe he'll invite you to help rebuild a new Lego creation. But even if he does not, you've done your part by being sorry and asking for forgiveness. When we choose to act like Jesus and have the Holy Spirit work through us, only God will know what may happen. Now, all glory to God, who is able through his mighty power at work within us to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask or think. Ephesians 3:20. Now, with that in mind, have a terrific week!